I'm Heidi Furman, I'm the current president, and...
Cindy Joy, the secretary.
And our other two offices are vacant right now, vice president and treasurer. For the financial report, starting with that, we started off the year with $3,882.85. As of January 8th, we had $4,092.88 in our account. Last month's expenses since our last meeting were, we ordered the baseball caps for our spirit wear, which we'll have for sale at the school store on Wednesdays and Fridays, and then we're going to look at the schedule for some of the spring sport events that parents and students can purchase on Wednesdays and Fridays during charger time. Sales tax we paid is $15.22. We gave Mr. Caputi $250 for academic bars and letters. And then we have $50 that will be taken out. It hasn't been taken out yet, but to pay for the carnations from our carnation grams. So our total expenses was $701.61. Revenue, spirit sales, we had $202 on the 13th of January. And February we had $174, and then we had $97 from the carnation grams. And then our total for that was $473. So our current balance as of today is $3,911.27. And the $50 will be taken out of that for the carnations. It hasn't come out yet. And then we had a request last meeting that we voted on, so we're gonna give Ms. Perlow $300. For the PBIS incentives for the kids. She's having a pizza party this week for them, since we no longer can do the donuts. So that will help offset the cost. So we're helping with that as well. Our upcoming fundraisers, or does anybody have a question about the budget? No.
Pardon my tardiness.
No, you're fine. I was late myself.
Thank you.
I forgot my bag. I had to go back and get it. One of those days.
Okay.
We just went over the budget part.
Already. Okay, thank you.
So we're down past the budget. Oh, and here is the sign in for that. Put that out too. For our upcoming fundraisers, we do have Chipotle scheduled for March 23rd. We put it out in the Lackey Lookout, so please check Ms. Perlow's Lackey Lookout, which goes out every other, no. This is the Lackey Lookout? No.
Every other week.
Yeah, Lackey Lookout every other week. That has been advertised the last time she put it out, and we'll advertise it again. If you can share it on social media, like, as many people as we can get, because we have to make at least $300 first before we can get any profit at all from it. So we really need to get as many people to go as possible. It's an easy way for us to help raise money so we can give it back to the school as well. I'm going to look at the schedule for spring sports and try to put out something if anybody wants to come sell spirit wear. We have our spirit wear locker. We'll have the hats and the shirts for sale. And then the other thing, I don't have any other spirit wearers. Foster's has never gotten back to me, and I haven't had a chance to speak to the manager, so I'll try to get that done this week and see if we can schedule a night. But we have to get people to go to these, or they're not going to give them to us. A couple restaurants that we had them with in the previous years told us that we couldn't have our spots back because they had to let other people. I think it's because of our low attendance. And we advertise it, we put it out there, but if the families, you know, the students don't go, I mean, it's because they want to make money too, the restaurants. We did Lido's in the past, and we did Pizza Hotline in the past. We used to do the barbecue restaurant that closed in La Plata, and we've done a couple other ones. I looked into Chick-fil-A, but their requirements are way too high for us to even touch. And you have to have people physically there to serve and things like that. So, like, pass out mints and clean the tables. And it's hard because our group is very small. So we don't have as many people in the PTSO as.
What about Silver Diner?
I haven't looked at we tried some water before, but the problem is that most of our families are down here, so we kind of stay to La Plata because people won't go to Waldorf.
Okay. I'm at, my daughter's at Henson, and
oh, is she?
We do a lot of Waldorf.
Oh, okay.
And I mean, it's not that much further, but
yeah, well, we can
just
look,
something to think about.
We can look into it. I mean, if they're willing to try, we can try it. But our experience in the past 3 years is the La Plata restaurants seem to do better. And there's really nothing down here in Indian Head that's really profitable for us to do a fundraiser with. These are easy fundraisers because you don't have to really put anything out. You're not losing money on them as long as you get people to go to eat. So it does help out. The only other thing I have on the agenda for now is for May, which would be Teacher Appreciation. In the past, we've done three things for the staff. On Monday, we usually do some kind of small treat. On Wednesday, we provided lunch for them. And on Friday, we've done some kind of dessert or something. So we've done Rita's before. And the owner of Rita's in La Plata is a friend of mine, so she usually gives us a pretty decent price for getting Rita's. And it's easy for Ms. Prilla because I can't physically be here. I'm a teacher at another school. So if I'm here, I have to take leave to be here. So it's hard for me to, you know, do that. So they'll deliver it to her, and she takes care of expressing it to the staff and passing everything out for us. And then that's what we've done in the past. If anybody has any suggestions, anything that we can do, I don't know, we're allowed to do the gift card thing like we did in the past, the $5 gift cards when we ask.
Yeah, we can do that. So we just kind of do drawings for
drawings,
the staff.
Drawings, yeah.
We can't purchase gifts.
No, not last year, but the year before we asked parents to donate $5 gift cards. And then we put them all in a box, and then they would draw teachers' names each day and give out some of the gift cards. So
and it ended up that year that every staff member got one.
We had over 150 donated. And I know $5 is an odd amount, but like you want them all to be equal.
Enough for coffee.
Yeah, it's enough. Yeah, Wawa. We said like Wawa. You know, McDonald's, Chick-fil-A. I mean, they're appreciative for that period. So that's what we asked for. And I mean, we could do that again. And then they come into the Miss Miller, and she keeps track of the financial secretary because we have to keep track of everything that comes in. So she'll keep track of what comes in and then what goes out, like who's given what. So we've done that before too, which worked out nice. Anything else anybody wants to suggest? Those are the only things on the agenda.
I'll be available for any event that you need me.
Okay, if you can do the luncheon this year, it's going to be that Wednesday. I think it's May 6th.
Okay.
Because I will not be able to take leave. And I think I'm going to ask, in the past, we had last year, yeah, it'd be May 6th, that Wednesday. Texas Roadhouse donated salads to us, which helps save the cost. So I will talk to the lady that's in charge of that and see if we can get salads donated again, because that will help cut down, like I said, us spending money out of our account. And then we'll probably just get the pizza from Pizza Hotline because they deliver down here and they do give us a decent price as well. And we used them before. And then I'll just order a big sheet cake from BJ's.
Okay.
So.
Will you be able to do anything for that day? Because I know last year you came in early and decorated.
Yeah, I might come in the night before or something and decorate. I won't be able to take leave that day.
Okay.
Yeah. But for me to take leave, I have to be either back by 11:45. I don't know. It's kind of tricky because I'm up in Waldorf too.
Right. I mean, I can come in the night before and help you decorate.
Yeah.
Whatever.
We can get it worked out.
Okay.
I will just help out.
Yeah, Miss Pearl is.
Except if it's a principal's meeting day. That's the only thing.
I don't. Is that the day for you?
Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be. It should be on the 13th. It should be the second
board
yeah.
meeting.
Yeah. We should be good.
Because this is Teachers Appreciation
right?
Week.
Okay. So I should be able to be okay.
Okay.
Yeah, they don't have it on the calendar, though.
They just have Teacher
Appreciation
Day,
on the 5th. But it's usually that week.
And also, one day that week, I usually do it on Friday.
Yeah.
The staff, they get to order a customized sub from Nick's of Clinton. So we give them an order form. They put their name on it. The Nick's makes the sub, puts their name. You know, we have their name. We group them by department here. They come in at lunch, pick up their sub. So that's, I think we do that on Fridays.
Mm-hmm.
So I might see,
if you all would be willing.
We could do it on Thursday, the
Rita's
Ice.
Ice, maybe on like a Thursday.
Yeah, we can
and
switch
then,
it.
And then maybe on Tuesday, I've done breakfast items and things of that nature. Like I might do, you know, or coffee and donuts and I'll do something the other days.
Yeah.
So the Rita's Ice.
They bring them in these big
things.
Big
and we scoop them. I do.
Okay.
Yeah,
we get two flavors.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're like in those big gallon, like
real
big drinking jugs.
Mm-hmm.
She makes it and puts it in there, and you just scoop it out.
Okay.
Yeah, we usually get, like she said, two flavors, and it's usually gone by the end of the
day.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah.
We usually get cherry and mango.
Yeah.
And
it's an easy treat, something to still them there. We're, you know, thankful for what they do for the kids.
Okay.
So that way, during that week, we have something every day.
Yeah.
So if on Monday you do the small treat.
We'll probably do the candy bars like I did before.
Okay. And then Tuesday, I'll probably do like a breakfast, like
bars.
A muffins, donuts, maybe coffee, and where they come in and get that. Wednesday would be the luncheon. Thursday could be Rita's Ice, and Friday could be the Nick's Sub, if everybody's okay with that.
That's fine. That works. So that covers that. And that's basically it. There's really not a lot. We haven't had a lot of requests for anything as of now. Like parents ask about the spirit wear, and like I send it out all the time. You know, it's available in the school store. Kids can pick it up if they want Wednesdays and Fridays. Ms. Watkins runs the school store for us. It's hard for us to be here for every sporting event. I did come to a couple of the basketball games and a couple of the girls' games and boys' games. It's hard to get the thing down to the swim, but I let them know I was here. But I can't be at every game. Because they'll say, can you be here? Are you going to be at the next game? And it's like, maybe. I can't be. And then you sit there for 2 hours and nobody buys anything.
You said which days is it available in the
school? Wednesdays and Fridays. She has the school store open during charger time. So students can buy, and we advertise it it's been in the Lackey Lookout every time when she sends the newsletter home to the parents. So if you're reading that, then you're able to see it. Because we don't send paper stuff home with the children. There's no notices that go home via paper. Very few. I haven't seen many. Yeah. Except for the senior packet, the senior announcement packet, which I had to ask for. That's because they hadn't told me about it. I was like, oh, I haven't seen that. So, so it's been in there. And Nikki's usually here every Wednesday. She volunteers and does a lot for us. She did the carnation grams for us. She came that day and delivered them for all the kids for us. She took the orders. She even came up on the Thursday and Tuesday before that and sold them down here by the cafeteria to try to drum up more business. We sold half the amount we did the year before, so it was kind of disappointing. We sold over 100 the year, like 100 the year before, and this year we only sold 50. So we tried. It was something different to try, something new. It's hard when you're competing against other groups too. So, and that's basically it. Unless anybody has any questions, I don't have anything new, except for we are going to need officers for next year because my daughter's a senior and is graduating. If Ms. Gilroy wants to stay and, you know, run again, but we will need somebody to step in and take over, otherwise it won't be existent. I don't know, I did put an email out saying if anybody's willing, you know, I'd like to train them, I can give them all my stuff. It's not a difficult position, it's not hard, you know, and you could organize it where you can get your members to sign up for things as well, so it'll help alleviate everything being on one person. If anybody's interested, please let us know, because next meeting we're going to have to vote, and if nobody runs, then there won't be a PTO for PTSO for next year. So.
Do you ever put out by email to take nominations?
I did. I put it out a couple times. I said, email
already
me if you're interested.
Year?
Yeah, I did. I sent one out I sent it out last month. You know, if you're interested, please let me know before the meeting so we can, you know.
And people don't mind, like, coming to the meetings, you know, just. Like I said, in the beginning of the year, it's much more attended. And the next month, you drop off a few people. And each month, as you get closer to the end of the year, it gets less attended. So, you know, in September, you'll have a good group. But
most people will say that they don't want the responsibility of being an officer. So that kind of,
I actually talked to some of the eighth grade parents that I have, that I'm friends with at Smallwood that are coming up. And I was trying to convince one of them to take the position. She's like, if you were there, I would do it with you, but I'm not doing it myself. So, I mean, there's a few really good parents coming up, you know, but they're afraid to step in, you know.
Yeah.
It's scary, but it's not that difficult. Like, really, the only thing that we've kept going here was the spirit wear for the students, which is nice because, like, athletics do their own spirit, their sports wear. But if you don't participate in a sport or something, there wasn't anything for the other students at the time. So when I started 3 years ago, when my daughter was a freshman, that's why I brought that here. I mean, I'm in elementary school, so we got spear wear galore. You know, I'm just used to every Friday, all the kids, you know, it's that camaraderie getting together and that feeling. So I wanted, you know, more of the staff and students to have that. They had their own, you know, different groups, but, and a lot of parents thank me for doing that, and especially the alumni when they come back to the football games. They're like, we never had this before. This is so cool, you know, thank you for doing it. And, you know, because they bought stuff.
We do have community members that do like to buy it,
mm-hmm.
you know, that they graduated from here 30 years ago and they mm-hmm. like to come to a game and buy, you know, some new spirit wear. So that's probably been the best fundraiser.
Yeah, that has been our best, and especially the football games. I mean, that season is the definite, you know, and I love being at the games with my kids anyways. For me, it was an excuse to be there, so my daughter couldn't say, why are you here? I'm part of it, and I enjoyed it. I really did.
And I don't want it to let it go. I want it to stay within the PTSO.
I know boosters are chomping to get it. So if, you know.
But I look at it, they make money on concessions.
They make
a lot of money. So I'm trying, since that's the main revenue coming in for the PTSO, I'd like it to stay PTSO.
And see, we support, they support the athletic department. We support more of the awards for the kids, the PBS incentives. We also support, you know, Miss Perillo with that, and then Mr. Caputi with the academic stuff, the academic letters and bars that the students get. And, you know, and we had students in the past ask for us to sponsor them for things. Nobody's asked recently, but I remember my second year, there was a student that went, she was doing some kind of conference, and she asked us to sponsor her. So we gave her some money and sponsored her so she could go to this conference. So, I mean, we can do other things, too, if they request it and we vote on it and it's, you know, within reasonable means. We can do that. Our account isn't as big as some of the other accounts, so we can't give everything away, but, you know, we try to give back to the teachers as well, because I feel it's very, very important that they realize that we care, and we, you know, that during that appreciation week that they realize that they're appreciated, because we get spoiled in elementary school. But our PTO, I mean, you have a Chick-fil-A night and you have half the school there, you know, you have 600 kids show up. That's elementary.
But they don't have evening sporting practices.
No, they don't have that.
They don't have that, so that's.
Yeah, so it's different elementary level.
Mm-hmm.
So, but that's basically, that's what we've been doing. All right, Ms. Perillo's going to do her report.
Last meeting I reported on, like, testing and our ESSA accountability and so forth. So tonight's report is brief. We are I'll start off with the honor roll reward, and that's because you all do help fund that. Okay, so the rest comes from general administration, which is like the principal's account that I have. And so you all agreed at the last meeting, you voted to transfer $300 for this event. Traditionally, what we have done every marking quarter is we have like a little incentive reward for honor roll. Well, not just honor roll, it's three components. The first one would be, you have to be an honor roll. It doesn't have to be principal's honor roll. It can be honor roll, high honors, or principal's honor roll. Second category is attendance. You have to meet that eligibility requirement, which is 4.5 days a marking quarter or less, okay? And then the third one is no behavioral referrals to the grade level administrators. So, and since this is my fifth year here, what we've always done is we've bought the colossal donuts from Shoppers Food Warehouse in Waldorf. So we would always put in a order for like 40 dozen donuts, and we would get orange juice, milk, those kinds of things. And we would do it in the morning, and we'd have 9th and 10th grade together, and 11th and 12th grade. We'd do it a couple periods in a day. And, you know, the kids really love the shoppers, those big filled donuts, and we have the sprinkles and all that kind of stuff on them. So they really enjoyed it. Well, this year, when it was time, when first quarter ended, it takes us a couple of weeks to get our data. You know, we have to wait for report cards to go out. We have to, you know, run our reports and so forth. So at that point, that's when Shoppers was closing, like, within a few days. I actually went to Shoppers and asked them, would they be able to do one last run for us of the donuts? And they said they didn't think they would have enough batter to make them. So it was, you know, we were in a quandary there. You know, we looked at Krispy Kreme and places like that, and it was like double the price. It was astronomical. So I brought it back to the group and everything. I talked to our instructional leadership team. We meet once a month on Tuesdays. And so what we did was we combined and made it for the semester, first quarter and second quarter. So if you were on the honor roll for both quarters, if you met the eligibility for both quarters, and if you didn't have any referrals from your teachers both quarters, you're eligible. It's going to be tomorrow and Friday. So the thing is, but we made it bigger. So that because they, you know, waited, we were delayed a quarter, we're doing pizza, chips, and soft drinks, or sodas, Cokes, and Sprites, and stuff like that. So the 9th and 10th graders will be tomorrow, and it's on the Friday focus. Last Friday it was on the calendar. 11th and 12th graders, Friday. And we're doing it at 11 o'clock because the earliest that I could get the pizzas delivered here was 10:45. So they're coming from Pizza Hotline, so it's like a big slice, you know, of pizza that they get. So the 9th and 10th graders that are eligible received an invitation today in their first period class. They were delivered, you know, by our student aides. And then tomorrow, our 11th and 12th graders will get their invitations. We don't want them to lose it. We tell them to bring it and stuff like that. So they will report to the cafeteria at the end of fourth period, which is like 11 o'clock about, and they'll go through. I mean, I always kind of like, I do some opening remarks and congratulate them, thank them for doing the right thing, and, you know, that kind of stuff. And then we will, you know, they go through the line and, you know, get their pizza, chips, and then they get the rest of the time, they just kind of eat or whatever. So that's the reward. And then for the next quarter, what we can do is, because the weather's warmer, we could probably do ice, the Rita's ice for the kids, you know, so that's something that we're looking at instead of the donuts or whatever. But I actually polled the kids. I brought in student leaders from our organizations, like the Honor Society, the Student Government, and, you know, Avid, whatever the various groups, and just talked to them and said, you know, in the past, they've always said they enjoy that donut and milk or donut and juice or whatever. So they kind of like some kind of a food item. So that's where we are. So, you know, this morning I actually started my day at Sam's Club, where I bought all the Cokes and, you know, Sprites, because we have a contract with Coca-Cola, so we use Coke products. And I got 12 cases of 35 packs of drinks. We have 404 students that are eligible. And we have, and that's for both quarters now. So that's, you know, and it's not quite 50%, but it's, you know, definitely like 45 to 46, which is good for both quarters. And then I bought all the chips and all that kind of stuff. And Pizza Hotline is supposed to be here at 10:45 tomorrow, and then back again on Friday. So
that's so they have to be one of those three things, not all three.
No, all three.
Oh, they have to be all three.
They have to be all three.
Okay.
Yes, all three. Mm-hmm. So, and we voted on that as a team, the staff, on what the criteria would be. So, now, if a student has like an M2, that does get deducted from, which is a doctor's note. Mm. So the M2 gets deducted, like a court summons would get deducted, and like a death, an O1 would be deducted, you know, for attendance purposes. But you got to have 4.5 or less, because that's what the eligibility requirement is to participate in extracurricular activities. Okay. Then the next item I have here is staff recognition. And we've had three teachers. I want to start with Mr. Bowser. He was our Teacher of the Year nominee. They did name Mr. Ball, who is an art teacher at North Point, as the Charles Callan finalist for the Maryland Teacher of the Year. But, you know, we certainly, we thank the world of all of our teachers, but we felt that Mr. Bowser would be a good candidate to put up for that award this year. He's a social studies teacher. Then Ms. Hoyler received a recognition from a local chapter auxiliary for teaching, and so she was recognized. And then most recently, we were notified that Ms. Bazell is our Math SMECO Teacher of the Year, so which is outstanding. And she will be recognized on like April 23rd up at Middleton Hall. And that's for, she's the Math Teacher of the Year for Charles County for at the high school level. And the teachers who receive this recognition from Calvert, St. Mary's, and Charles will all be in attendance, okay? So Ms. Bazell received it this year. Last year, we had Mr. Fawcett, who received it for STEM. And then the year before that, Ms. Laverty was the math SMECO. So we've had, you know, 3 out of my 5 years a SMECO winner, which is very good. Okay. The only other thing I put here, because I just want parents to know, on Fridays, you know, I send the Friday focus with the events and so forth. And I always have little blurbs, usually congratulations to this group or thank you to this group. But I also put sometimes some messages in there about things that need to be addressed. You know, sometimes it can be parents who park in, or, you know, in the, you know, the wrong area of school, or friendly reminder to drop by. I do those kind of courtesy, you know, reminders and so forth. So a couple of weeks ago, maybe more than a couple weeks ago now, I sent a message that I was going to suspend charger time for a day, which I did, on a Monday. And the reason why, when I do something like that, of course, I don't just say I'm doing it. I talk to my vice principals, and we discuss it and so forth. And a lot of times, they're the ones that'll say, I think we need to do something. So on this particular one, like I think it was a Friday, the bell rang for charger time. So they've had an hour. Students have had an hour to do whatever they need to do. Eat, go to the bathroom, go to a teacher, you know. They get longer than our staff have, you know, who don't eat or do anything like that, or administrators. And the bell would ring. And they're just in the hallways. And I'm not talking 5 to 10 kids. We can handle 5 to 10 kids. I'm talking like 100 or so kids. And so I've been getting on the intercom in the morning, and Ms. Alvarez will attest to this, and the language I use is, the bell is not a suggestion. It is a mandatory time that you need to be in class. If you're not there, you're considered tardy. So, I mean, we have put some students in Saturday school and things like that, but I'll be honest, a bulk of it are our freshmen, are our ninth graders. They're very, I know, and you would think that's not the case, but it really is. And they just kind of, I'm not going to say all, because I don't, you know, I'm not going to be, you know, that would be a big statement to make, but I'm going to say that maybe close to a quarter of our freshman class have this, like, they don't really listen to adults that well. So just something like, you know, no one's yelling, no one's doing things like, hey, we need you to get to class or whatever, and they just kind of move at their snail's pace, and if they get there 10 minutes late. Class is only 45 minutes. But then what happens is that parents are concerned, like, why my kid missed this, or why my kid, or, you know, whatever. So, you know, I got a couple emails from parents saying, like, I don't believe everybody should be, you know, should be miss charger time. And those are the parents whose kids are doing what they need to do, but they don't understand that we're talking like 100 and some kids in the hallway. That is too many for us to handle and getting to where they need to be. So I just ask for your support. When you see that, please know that decisions are not made in isolation. It's based on data, and that something needs to be done to fix it. Okay? Any questions about that? Okay. Thank you.
Basically, they just had us in training. I had contacted you about that, but due to our low turnout, Heidi and I decided that, you know, it's probably not worth. They offer to have people come in and do the training, and I know Ms. Perlona is about that, about mm-hmm. the what do I wanna call it, stars, not stars, what is that, you know what I'm saying? When the kids have adverse, ACEs.
Right.
The, students with ACEs, adverse childhood experiences. So when, so you can get a better understanding maybe why they're not going. But sometimes, you know, I mean, people still have to follow rules, but anyway, but we always have such a low turnout in our PTO that we didn't wanna have a special presenter come out here for three people. And look, the own board person who read the email, I apologize. I had a rough day today, I read the email and I was just sitting there, I was like, oh God, I was supposed to be there. I apologize. But, basically, the PAC meetings have now, they really don't ask for a whole lot of input. They mainly have us doing little, workshops, shall I say?
Well, I suggest that they're gonna schedule something, they schedule at the beginning of the year, next year, when, you know, like I said, for the first or second meeting, when there is a larger turnout. And maybe have Mr. Stoddard, the security guy, also come in at the beginning of the year, you know, and address the, you know, come in and present to his parents, but I would do that at the very beginning of the year.
Right.
You know, I mean, you can schedule people, but like you said, you're, you don't want people, you don't wanna schedule somebody, they come all the way down here, and then nobody's here for them to present to.
Right.
So.
So anyway, that's basically it in a nutshell, they're working on that, they really, are focused on that type of thing, training and stuff like that, and I believe they said all the principals have gone through the training, but they're putting the teachers.
We're doing a book study.
Doing, yeah, okay, I have that book, yeah. Okay. So, basically, that's all I have to report from there. I have to show up to see what happens.
We really have like two more sessions.
And that's it. If anybody wants to think about considering running for office, please email me. You can email the PTO email or hferman@ccboe.com. Let me know, and that way, cause May 6th is our last and final meeting of this year, and yeah, and Ms. Adams will be leaving too, her daughter's a senior as well.
I believe we had someone at the last meeting say they would step in for PAC, because they were doing Smallwood anyway.
Sahana's mom.
Oh, Ms. Vegetash.
Yeah, I believe.
Yes.
She does the PAC at the middle school.
Well, that's good. She can continue on.
And a perk of being an officer with the PTSO is, that when your child graduates, then you are, you receive a VIP invitation. So you get, before graduation, there's, depending upon which one you're scheduled for, you get either the breakfast, lunch, or dinner. For, you know, you and your, you know, someone, you know, a guest, another guest or whatever, and then you get VIP seating tickets for graduation. So, the one thing that I'm gonna make sure I do is that I'm gonna try to get the tickets to the parents, because sometimes the kids don't give them to their parents. I learned that a couple of our booster officers didn't get their tickets to their, you know, are there VIP, you know, we do a nice little invitation, we hand it to them, we think you're seniors, you're going out in the world, you would be responsible to give this to your parents, and I'm like, flabbergasted when I, you know, I went to a couple of groups, but I didn't see you at the reception, you missed a great lunch, and they're like, what are you talking about? So, I mean, that is a perk that you know, you get, you know, which is, it's a very nice event. This year, our graduation, we have the 7 p.m. one on a Friday night, so I like the first one. I like the 9 a.m. one the best.
I have to have an early dinner.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to eat afterwards, it'll be too late.
And so ours is going to be 7 p.m. And so that means it'll be a dinner for the group this year for the VIP reception. And it's held, you know, in the staff development room at North Point, but they make it look very nice. And our instrumental music students from the orchestra play, and you know, and so the officers of the PTSO, the officers of the athletic boosters, and then the parents of the valedictorian, salutatorian, and you know, those in the top 10 students in the top 10, so their parents, you know, get invited to that.
Okay.
So you've only been doing that? Okay. Because Donovan never gave me one. I've been doing
that. That was something that I did for the PTSO.
I didn't get it from Donovan.
Hey, you've served. Thank you.
Oh, well,
Here is, this is my appreciation for you doing that.
Thank you.
So something to consider, even if you're early in your high school journey.
I'm going
to
appreciate it because I've been doing this for 23 years.
I know you have. Yes. I know.
That's going to be nice. Yeah. That's what I said when I said realized I forgot. I was like, oh God, it's after six. It's like, let me go. This is it. This is last year. Push.
That was good. You got your tickets last year.
Well, you know, it was at the door when I handed in my ticket. Uh-huh. They were like, oh, you're VIP. And I was like, I am? And they're like, yeah, your ticket's a different color. Uh-huh. And before that second, no clue. Nothing.
Well, thank you for telling us.
Yeah, I think I would contact the parents, email the parents, letting them know that they're VIP and this is what you should expect to get from your child.
Right.
Just like when I went to the flower shop and Anne said, did you get your thing for the announcements? No, what announcements? What are you talking about? And I go, hey, Maddie, did you get this? Oh, this thing? And she pulls out of her backpack and throws it to me. I got that weeks ago. Great. Thanks.
We do communicate.
I try, But, the teenagers just don't have all that on their minds.
Yeah.
They're worried about other things.
So the two of you with senior children can expect.
Yay.
Thank you. All right. I guess we're done. Meeting adjourned.